Hey everybody, I'm Cinnamon Cooney, your Art Sherpa. On the mic today is my husband, John.
Hi guys.
This is going to be kind of a crazy, different arting day than we usually have because we are in 100K watch.
We are.
I live through Panda Watch. I was there, San Diego, for Panda Watch. And that was a real thing. That wasn't just on Ron Burgundy. The Eye on San Diego, that was all true. That was just a documentary. You just don't even know. I've been there for all kinds of watches, hurricane watches, but this is our 100K watch, so we're watching it. John's going to put up a live counter.
I am.
And I'm going to do kind of a demo painting, which you can totally paint along with me. I'm going to completely explain what I'm doing while we're doing that. And this is going to be, a lot of you guys have asked me for eagles, and a lot of you guys have asked me for some more fanciful imaginative pieces, so I'm going to paint how I feel about hitting 100K,
because oh,
I feel pretty good.
We got a little window up there.
When we were baby YouTubers.
We're still baby YouTubers.
We are, actually. This is, you don't know this one, but when we started out, you know, at the beginning of the journey.
In the beginning.
You dream.
In the beginning, there was...
You dream.
There was some... camcorders.
Yeah, and you don't know.
Cameras.
You don't know how you're going to get there, and you dream and you hope and you think maybe someday if I do a really good job, I could get there.
Could.
Get a button and and do. Oh, look, there's somebody joined us. Thank you, somebody.
It goes up and down and up and down.
So if you know anyone that loves art and loves countdowns, this is a good time to share it. If you're on Facebook, hi. If you're on Twitch, hi. If you're on YouTube, hi, we have moderators everywhere. They're going to be forwarding your questions to us, mm-hmm. and we're going to attempt. Oh, hi, 53. We're going to attempt to be here.
And we're going to greet everyone on the way up.
Check if you have been unsubscribed. Many of you might be saying, oh, somebody said no. They said no, we won't help you.
No.
Check and see if you've been unsubscribed to from YouTube. This is for YouTube subscription, but you can come in and follow us on Twitch. Mm-hmm. You can come in and like the page on Facebook. This stuff is happening here all the time. What we do is we just teach art for free.
Mm-hmm.
You know, usually quicker than this. This is a party show.
Actually, I don't know if I would say that. I don't
know
saying
do.
That we're
in an hour, you get a lesson out of it.
It's sort of true.
This one, we're like, let's marinate in our joy. Oh, look, more people. They're like, some people are like, you suck. Then they're back. I love subscriber count. It's one of the great joys of new YouTube features that you can find. They're everywhere. This one, I think, is this Social Blade? Who is this?
Yes, that's Social Blade. Yeah. And you know, we have people.
They grade me,
the
which
world.
I can't tell y'all how much that stresses me out because I really was about straight A's in school. So the grades on Social Blade work me more than they should.
Well, I'm going to give some quick shout outs to all of our community.
Yeah, shout them out. Shout out who's here. Let's shout out
who's here. We've got over 200. I mean, like, it's just going up, like 260, 270. It's just going up and up and up on YouTube. So many people there.
Thank you, YouTube, from the bottom of our heart.
There's 23 hard fought people over on Twitch. And if you know how big that is, that's like we're over halfway up the stack.
We know
Twitch.
We gotta earn our space.
We gotta
on Twitch,
earn it.
Guys. We know it.
We're coming.
We respect it. We're ready to pay dues.
And
we
Facebook,
came to pay the dues, Twitch.
And all of our Facebook people
and,
are
and
like,
we know we've got a we what? Big shoes to fill with the Bob. What about Facebook?
Facebook's all like, what's going on?
Hi, Facebook. Facebook has, I don't know if you've noticed, but Facebook is very proud of its new live feature, which has been advertising on all the cable networks.
So we're
live. So we're livin'.
We're livin'.
Just in case you're stuck in an airport and this is what you got on your phone. You're like, oh, look, mobile optimized Facebook to kill the time of this long airport wait.
That's what we're here for you.
We're here for you.
If you're doing cardio, we're here for you.
We have that. Apparently, I'm a good cardio. It's probably John's music mix.
No, I don't. So I'm going to say real quick, I'm going to say thank you to all the people all over the world who are hanging out with us, especially our moderators, Janine and Mona and Lisa.
And the people who have been here since the beginning.
And
a shout out Angela Maxwell.
And all
of Faith.
And Faith. And seriously, guys. And Sandy and Christy and
Never
Daisy and
speech.
All you guys. I could just go on and on and on.
We can.
And, Kim,
and we should go on and on.
And
many of you have been here since the beginning. We're quiet.
Yeah. And like so many of you who were just here just quietly along with us, you know, Judy and Judith and my gosh, it just all the names, Stephanie, you know, got, you know, and Mark and Kim and
so
Kim
many
and Kim.
Marks, so many Kims.
We could say thank you here all day. We
Kim
really
one, Kim
honestly
two, Kim
could.
Three, Kim and four, Kim five.
We love you guys.
And
we're going to say, you know, thank you. Thank you for everything. And we won't go on too long because we want to paint some stuff here with
we
you today.
We don't want to paint, but we can say thank you. This is the thank you day, right? We got to thank you. We're not, you know, sometimes you have a hydraulic press and gummies. And so therefore you have YouTube lightning in a bottle, right?
Mm-hmm.
You have video lightning in a bottle because you have a really cool Russian accent.
That's true.
And you have these gummies and a sense of humor and you're going to get 100 million views. But it's when you're a dorky, goofy chick with a hat and a sweet man with a dream that people around the world should be able to paint and be creative and that should be free. And it should be out there for everybody. Everybody should have access to their creativity. That's a tougher dream to sell.
The most cutting edge digital technology art painting show in the world.
It really is. Look,
we've gotten here because of you guys. And really, we are. I mean, like, we have more students painting with us, more paintings being done with us than anybody else living today. Thank you, guys. Without you guys doing that, we couldn't be here. We couldn't be doing this with you. It's the
shares and the love and just the bravery to be like, you know, I'm going to listen to that crazy chick and that crazy guy. And I'm going to get a canvas and I'm going to put some paint to canvas and I'm going to give it a go. And I can't tell you how thrilling it is every day to get messages from you saying, I didn't know I could.
Yeah.
But I can. I love that.
We are Sherpa together. And that's, you know, I think that's the greatest part of this journey is that, like, we've taken this with you guys, you know, with your artwork and sharing that with you. And that's been so meaningful to us and the stories that you guys share with us.
The fellow YouTubers that have been here for us.
Oh, my gosh.
Who were like, no, I know you feel like you're insane, but it's a good idea. Hang in. Just cling to your little ledge and hold on. You're going to make it.
We've made so many friends along the way at the VidCons and the conventions and... You know, and this is just sort of the beginning of it all. We, you know, because
YouTube next up.
Yeah, YouTube next up.
YouTube.
You know, the YouTube business building workshops.
Woo!
You know,
that was awesome.
The the shooting in the YouTube studios. We've been.
I'm not saying
New York,
we make good
LA.
Movies, but they let us make movies.
And we're going to be doing more. And this next year is even more exciting.
You know? All right. You keep going. I'm going to start sketching in.
So tell us what you're sketching in.
So I wanted to do an eagle. My idea here was an eagle because I really like eagles. I like the sense of freedom and flight and that they're raptors. And whenever I see large raptors in nature, my dad used to fly hang gliders. So what this is my dad used to fly hang gliders. And so I have an affinity or a sense of particular love to things that fly. There's a whole long story where my dad taught a flock of ducks to fly. I know you're thinking of the little girl and the geese. That's a different story. My dad's was not made into a movie. But nonetheless, they flew.
You've got some wishes there. So tell me about your wishes.
I have some wishes. I have one. Okay, this is a goofy, dorky self-interest wish. Shameless self-promotion wish. Soaring to 1 million subs.
I think that's a good wish for us. You know, I'm happy with that wish.
You're okay with that wish?
I love that wish. That's a good wish.
Okay. This one is also world peace and art.
I think that's another good wish.
I just like people around the world to paint and know that they can and know that they have value and they're creative regardless of borders and culture and wherever we are on this rock, that we have that creativity in common as a species. And then more healing and art for the world.
Yep.
There was a bunch of hit and run car messages and wishes. There was one particular one of a little boy who... He's okay,
yeah.
But we want to wish that he continues to heal. But he's not the only one. There's a lady's husband was returned home, and I just have seen a lot of hit and runs in my Facebook feed. So I'm putting that wish in there that everybody has car safety.
A good friend of mine, Kevin, got accidentally backed into with a car about a year ago, and it was just like really, I mean.
So you've been hit by a car. So safety
car.
For all.
No car hitting people.
Look out for pedestrians, please, and cyclists just in general. And well-being and hope to all. Because I think right now in the world, I think regardless of where we live and what we have going on, I think all of our hope and well-being has been shaken in some way by something.
Mm-hmm.
And I just like us all to find that sense of being okay and connected to each other.
Yeah.
Right? To see those divides close and us to go back to being the weird little species that we are on planet Earth. So I kind of lightly sketched him in, but I'll talk a little bit about how I did that. So my idea here is everything below here is going to be some sort of galactic space.
Mm-hmm.
And everything above here is going to be some sort of dawn sky space. And he is night and day as he soars through transition. And I'm hoping he'll be my spirit animal over the next year and soar me through all those ever-changing ebbs and flows that are digital media and helping people paint around the world. And take me on my next journey. And maybe a journey to all of you. That's what I wish. A journey to all of you. Let's put that wish in.
Ooh.
That we get to take a journey into all of our community.
Mm-hmm. Kim Mayberry says, ding, everyone here is an artist. We agree.
It's official now.
And all the little brushes that are with us. I mean, I know we got a bunch here. Hi to everybody who's hanging out with us. And for all the ones that are sleeping right now, yep. And they're going to be up in a little while, hi to you.
Hi to you.
So well, what are you doing there? What are you drawing with?
The first thing I did is I knew I wanted to divide this space. And the first thing I did to get him is I got this little egg shape in, which kind of let me know generally where his skull would anchor. But the interesting thing, and if you think of Muppets, remember those weird beagles and the Muppets? They're very informative about the sternness
of raptors'
faces.
That's true.
What I like to do is follow the sternness of those lines and the sternness of the beak.
Uh-huh.
You know? And actually, it just occurred to me, John was telling me I don't have the reference photo.
Oh, I can do
until
that.
Later, but that might make him hard to paint. How do we get to do that?
How will I do that?
I don't know. I'm sketching now. I've got some stuff I can lay in for a little bit.
What I can do is I will take down the reference meter for just a second here, because we can come back to it in a bit. Hold on a second.
We've shared him a couple places, so you guys can use him as a reference. I'm just laying out my wings. And it was just about finding his space. I don't need to be very specific down here, because I know I'm going to blend a galactic fantasy happening here.
And again,
don't need to be that specific here, because I know I'm going to be creating some type of dramatic sunrise event
above him.
Does that
help you over there?
Huh?
Look behind you and see if that helps you. Is it on your screen? Does your screen have a reference photo?
No, my screen has an eagle.
Your eagle. That's what you want.
No, it just has me drawing an eagle.
Oh, sorry. It doesn't have.
Sorry, it wasn't clear.
Is that better?
Yes, that's so helpful. Okay, so now I see his lighting. I picked this particular reference photo because of his intense topside lighting, and it was going to allow me to merge the idea of the dawn here versus the dark underneath. I don't know if anyone gets to see him, but
I'm working on that right now.
He'll be shared, and all the traceable will be shared. But the reason why I picked that was I was looking for something that already possessed a good lighting that was synergistic to my creative idea. You know. So here we go. I've got that sketched in, and I'm going to put out some paint and start thinking about those things.
I think that I can. Oh, bang! Look at that. Oh, wait. Hold on, you can't see it.
Okay. That's okay. Then I won't look. I'm going to just work.
See, that's what they get to see. Look what they're seeing. They got it up there.
Oh, perfect.
Does that work for you?
Does that take away, though, their countdown?
Yes.
That, I don't know, man.
I can't.
You guys vote. Do you need the countdown?
Well,
Tell us around the intertubes.
I'll bring the countdown back when we get close.
Okay. When we get close, we'll bring the countdown back?
Yeah. I'm sure people in chat will also be, like, warning me.
They are really good at warning us.
Yes. What's the hexagonal metal thing on your eraser? On your easel?
This?
Where? I'm not sure.
This is my pencil sharpener.
Where?
Color grip.
Oh, there. That thing.
Universal pencil sharpener.
Oh, okay. What is that?
I got lipstick. So my easel will always have a couple lipsticks. Those of you who've been with me for a while know that's true. What is she going to have up there? A bunch of lipstick.
Yeah.
Because, you know, once the lipstick is on, the art party's going on.
He's happening.
It's happening. Some people put... Violet puts her hair back. I put my lipstick on. We all have our little space. I'll tell you the colors I'm putting out. I kind of grabbed a smorgasbord of color.
Yeah.
Because I knew I'd be just goofing around. You know what I didn't grab?
No.
Always something, right?
Yep. What did you not grab?
I did not grab... both my mister and my glazing medium.
Mister and glazing medium.
I did.
Okay, I can look for those.
Why didn't I do that, John? Do not reapply your caps the way I do. I suck at that. Thank you. The mister, which I'm going to have to see if I can refill with some water somehow. Joel's like, please stop helping yourself. You're so awkward. Here's an interesting color I'm going to pull out today in my space and sunrise is quinacridone red. You don't have to have it. You don't have to have any of these colors. You just generally need to know what kinds of colors I'm using. Are they warm? Are they cool? Are they generally purple? They generally blue. That was dioxazine purple. I got a brand new tube. Look at my brand new tube. I love new tubes. And you can really see how like chromatically deep that is. The mister. My studio is an easy bake oven. And the mister helps me prolong the life of my paint. So I'm just putting out a bunch of colors that I think will aid me.
Yeah.
In my goal of painting these things. You know, you got to do that.
Yes.
Yep. Aid yourself. I might treat myself to some quinacridone nickel azo gold. You don't need to have this. It's just one I love. And so I'm painting for me today and I'm painting for you today to celebrate.
Yes.
In lessons, normally we just explain every single step of a painting so that you can paint it. This is Indian yellow, which you can, I'll really show you how close it is to Australian Sienna. It's kind of, y'all might not know how close those are in formulation, but they're pretty darn close. They're like a shade off each other.
Ooh.
So if you'd ever wondered, if you'd had that burning question, glazing medium?
Glazing? I think I handed it to you.
No, you handed me a mister.
No.
Oh, you did. Wow.
Stunt hands.
Stunt hands is on point. Sherpa is lost in the painting. All right, so I have a bunch of colors out here. I have quinacridone red.
And the community would like to have you squeeze in one more wish in there for Mona. Yeah,
Mona, sure.
We've just put in a wish for Mona, who will be watching with us later. She's sleeping right now. And, you know.
Oh, Mona, we all
love
you.
Yeah, put some special
love in there. Just in case you didn't know, girl. Just in case you didn't know. I also have this weird fluorescent purple, which may come out during the galaxy. Now, one cool thing I can hit now, I've got to paint in some stuff, and then I will come in and put out some black, even though I don't generally. I'll tell you about my
Mona
paint.
Is here.
Hi, Mona.
Oh, okay. Hey, Mona.
Mona is here.
I was like,
she's
I figured,
so quiet. We don't know.
I figured she would be sleeping because it's like so crazy on different times of all over the place. So
I get quinacridone red, cad yellow light, titanium white. This is the Indian yellow, and this is Australian Sienna. You can see why I'm saying that they're very exchangeable. Cad yellow light, I think, on this one. Then I have the nickel azo, and I have the burnt sienna, and the yellow oxide, some phthalo blue, some dioxazine purple, some teal. You know, your Southern Ocean blue will work for that. You know, teal mm-hmm. or your turquoise. You're just trying to get something in that profile. Some glazing medium. And then I'm going to get my brushes, and I'm going to start putting this bad boy in, man. I'm going to put them in. I'm feeling everything. I like to feel my brushes before I get into it.
Yeah.
It's like, who pleases me today? It's so funny. All right, there he is. So I'm going right. to start putting him in. And he needs to be sort of interesting, I think. So I'm going to make some interesting color choices, perhaps with him.
Would
get my cad red light over here.
Now, would golden turquoise phthalo be a close substitute? Yeah. Substitute for Matisse's Southern Ocean Blue?
Yes.
Oh.
Yeah, you're good there.
That was a mouthful that I barely got out.
Yeah. You know, there'll be differences, right? But sometimes they're so close that for all intensive purposes, you're like, okay, I'm just good here.
Yeah.
You know. And I'm looking at that. And I'm thinking about the journey. And this is not a singing show, so I'll stop. So I'm just very lightly... If you paint with me a long time, you know that I'm dry brushing. I don't have a lot of moisture uh-huh. in my brush right here. It's just the pigments on the tip. This is a more advanced piece if you're wondering the hoots on this.
Yeah.
For those of you who are like, how many hoots? Guys, all the hoots.
We'll take a quick peek over there and just see.
How it's going?
How it's going. Let's take
How's
a quick
How's it going,
look.
Man?
Let's see here how it's going over there.
Luckily, he's a fantasy eagle, so I have some room.
Oh, there it is. So we got, it looks like
Ooh.
965. So we're doing pretty good over there.
We're doing pretty good, guys.
Yeah.
What is this? I'm going to be doing the top of him in very, very warm colors because he will be very impacted by the sunlight that's on him. And then as we move down him, right? He's going to become cooler.
Now, how many hoot difficulty do you think this is?
This is in a sense, all the hoots. This mm-hmm. is for my quest. You know, my questers would follow along with this. If you were like, you got through the blue door mm-hmm. without the lesson, you'd probably follow along with this. This is about what all these art skills are for.
Gotcha.
What do you do with them? When you get to use your imagination. I'm going to add some glazing medium. You get to add your imagination and play with your world.
Now, what is the glazing medium looks like? It's made it transparent there.
It is. My glazing medium allows me to do thin, transparent coats and also slows the drying time down on my paint. It's going to really help during the galaxification of this eagle.
Ah.
It's going to really help. And that's what I'm going to be doing is I've got to make these transitions from his sunny side space.
We have a lot of new people from joining us here.
Do we?
Yeah.
So, guys, normally you check out the rest of our tutorials, which are all free. They're step by step. They're what builds up to the space so you can paint like this. I think you can paint like this.
Now, did you
give it enough aid?
Did you gesso this canvas black?
I did. You did, actually.
I did. So
you did, and it was interesting. I'm taking a little my phthalo, my little Dioxazine, just on bead here, and I'm gonna come.
So you can start with any white canvas and then just use some black gesso or black paint if you don't have black gesso, right?
Yeah.
So and you like the black because you're going to let it bleed through.
I'm going to let that, show through. You can do any colored gesso. This is about using a colored ground mm-hmm. to paint from so that what's underneath begins to impact what's up top like you do.
Yeah, we're going to leave this one up on YouTube.
Yeah, we'll leave this up. This isn't, this is more, I think, a demo than a...
It's kind of an interactive painting.
Yeah, because you can ask me any questions you want and talk to me about how this is being made. And then if you're ready to start painting, if you're ready to begin your painting journey and be part of that next March to a Million, you sub and you follow along wherever you're at, Facebook or YouTube or... wherever you're at, and just follow along with us, and you're going to find yourself able to paint like this.
Yeah. And as you can see, we could be here a little while today.
So we picked a kind of chompy project.
Yeah. So this one.
Big bites.
We'll see how it goes.
Yeah. Right. I love his stern little.
I'm an eagle, so I have to have an eyebrow that stares angrily to space.
I'll bring our
looking
reference
for little
photo
mice
back up here.
To eat. Sorry,
yep. That's what my eagle says. What does your eagle say today? So that's what's fun for me is like, ooh, I'm gonna, you know, how we come along here and there's gonna be several layers. The first thing in painting is always, especially when you're trying to create an original piece. I get asked that all the time. How do I create original art? Like, yeah, I can follow along a tutorial, but how do I start making original art? And I keep notebooks of ideas. A lot of artists I know do this.
There you go.
Is he back? Thank you.
There you go.
And, you know, I keep my notebooks of ideas and I think about it and I save and interact with things that appeal to me. Mm-hmm. And I take little notes like, why is this meaningful? Why do I care? Why do I care? I don't know. Let's find out. And I make little notes why I'm caring about some particular piece. So like in this, you know, I've been playing with this idea of the freedom and birds and stuff. And then... you know, I've been playing with the ideas of universal truth and stream of consciousness painting.
Oh, so much love coming in from all over the place.
Thank you.
So you get some love from Croatia, some love from...
Love to Croatia.
Love from France and from Australia.
I come from France. Sorry. There's no way that wasn't happening in France because I'm a total Conehead fan.
And thank you guys all for coming and hanging out with us here. And they were wondering, so where do you get your black canvases?
Well, this is just a 12 by 16 canvas that I took black gesso to. But a lot mm-hmm. of craft stores now have pre-gessoed black canvases. And the issues that you have in the white gessoed canvases do not seem to be impacting the black gesso. So it has a beautiful tooth and it's really taking paint great, and it doesn't, it generally, is that her? Is that Twix? It doesn't really necessarily fight back the way that the others have. But you can just buy colored gesso now, or make it, because that's just, you know, pigment and gesso.
Yeah.
So you can kind of see he's like taking shape.
Taking.
Sailing. We're not doing John's really cool music today.
Because it, they don't let it
pulled
stay.
Us down, man.
Well, there's, yeah. So it's not my music to use. So what we realized is that in, you know, looking at the rules around this, what we can do is we can have live only performances where we use other music in a live performance environment. But once that goes off of live, it can't stay. So that's where the rules and laws around that kind of are.
Yeah.
So that we can come up on Twitch and we can kind of do, or even YouTube, and we can do some live performances and we're all totally okay there. But we just can't leave that stuff up afterwards.
It says no.
It says no. But we're going to do more of that now that we understand it and how it works. We're going to intentionally go out there with a plan of like making some content that's one-off.
It's one-off. I don't know. John should be playing something nice today, though, I think.
I'm playing some gentle dance grooves.
Some gentle jazz.
No, dance grooves.
Some soul moves, some dance grooves. What do you got going?
Can't you hear that?
Okay. You got some stuff afoot.
Just kind of leaving some music going there.
I love birds' wings.
I do too.
So well engineered. I mean, I wouldn't want to run into anything from, like, you know, say a dinosaur period.
Mm-hmm.
You guys know how I feel about that. Don't remake dinosaurs. That's not that's not cute. Bring back the dodo bird if you can bring something back.
So how long does it take you to design a painting? How long does it take you to design a painting?
So the external, where you see it, it feels like it comes together so quick. Like John has talked about this, like, oh, you just throw that down and it won't be anything.
Mm-hmm.
But really what's happening is I get an idea in my noggin.
Yeah.
And it starts pesting me. And it starts saying, oh, you wanna do something about this. I want to talk to you about this. I want to do a painting that's about this space. And then...
Now, I'm just kind of wondering, because your eagle looking kind of technicolor here.
He is.
Yeah. It doesn't look very eagly right now.
He will.
It's looking like a kind of like a parrot.
So what I love about painting, especially acrylic, is there's this just what the blank phase.
Uh-huh.
Right? Where you're like, you got an idea, you know the layers. Because once you art, you know, once you've kind of got your skills together.
Yeah.
Right? You're like, oh, I got my art skills. I know what I'm doing. And you're working these things out, right? And you're layering your paint. There's this jacked up stage.
Uh-huh.
I would say he's in a colorful space. I John remembers this. I used to, the gallery, one of the galleries I was hung at locally, would have artists sit in the mall and paint, like, to get people to come in.
Mm-hmm.
And so you'd sit out there very exposed to the public and you'd be there through this stage, and of course people would come in up like, I don't get what you're doing here at all.
Yep.
This is are you sure you can paint? I've really had people ask me like, are you sure you can paint? Like, yeah, no, I'm pretty sure. I got it. Nope. And then they'll come back through the day, especially the skeptics.
No, I'm...
They'll come back through the day. If you're a skeptic, I would suggest keep coming back, because there's a point when this comes together in the last third where you're going to be like, that's the best thing I've ever seen in my life, and it resolves so many issues from my childhood.
So... you have to, now it's gratuitous plug and call to action time.
Sure, do it.
So we have to go, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share.
Tell
all
your friends.
Come and join us live. Do all the places. Like, you go to, wait, I have buttons. Hold on.
Your buttons?
Let me push a button. Go up, and then go, whoa, there we go. www.theartsherpa.com, places where you can go hang out with everybody else. All the Sherpettes are out there. We have live chat. And if you go to shop, theartsherpa.com.
No.
Shop.theartsherpa.com. You could find all of the crazy stuff.
Sherpa gear.
You have a mug there, don't you?
I do. I have a mug. I have many mugs.
Today's
mug is the girl in the red dress, which is a painting tutorial you can do. And then you can have the matching mug.
Look at this. We're getting
just to sit in your house like when your company's over. Imagine this. You do this epic painting. Nobody who knows you knew you could paint. So you're already sitting there kind of like chuffed up going, yeah. painted that. And then you can just, you know, nonchalantly sip out of your mug, you know, and that's sort of like,
how cool am I?
You know, let them process the experience. You'd be like, yeah, I don't know what you were doing with your week. I arted and have a mug.
Who would have thought 100,000 people ago that we would have, you know, and we're double Sherpa on YouTube.
I'm still shocked that anybody comes now.
Look at, they're telling me over here. I'm going to go back over and look real quick.
What are we?
We're double Sherpa on YouTube. Our 300. We have 357 people watching.
We are Sherpa.
So I'm going to come over and give you a quick okay. kiss and dance. And
bubbles? Everybody dance.
Love you guys.
He didn't really dance. I swear it won't clean you.
Attacked by the bubbles.
At some point, the puppy, like, the puppy's very into the bubbles. Ah, the painting.
And so, and that's what it does, is it makes, it cleans your painting.
I'm not saying this is good for your art. I'm just saying I'll get away with it because I'm painting with really good paint.
Yeah. It's, you know, actually, we're going to have some stuff on that a little later.
You've had an experience today.
I had an experience today that was awesome.
You got to share your experience. Out yourself.
I'm actually going to save this. This is so
good. Are you?
It was so good.
But then they'll know why the video was made. Okay.
Okay.
I'm going to let you have your artistic space. I would never take that from you.
So I'll tell them. So what happened was is today when I was doing this, when I was setting up for the show, Cinnamon needed a black gessoed canvas, right? So she was running out and grabbing some Starbucks, and I went ahead and...
Because there's no art show without Starbucks. This isn't a plug. They don't sponsor nobody. I'm just telling you, there's no art show without Starbucks.
Right. So, yeah, and don't mind the Technicolor bird. It will turn into an eagle, we promise.
It is. It's going to look like, it will be better than that picture, and it will be better than anything you ever imagined. And you'll be like, wait, how did that happen? Just working him out. Because I got to get his space, and then I'm going to get this space. And then I go back and get his space. It's going to be so awesome. Sailing.
Sorry, I was. Kids were there. Okay, so real quick from the top, we had some questions.
Oh, I'm so happy! I love answering the questions.
Who is Twitch?
Twix is our new puppy.
Our new puppy. Who is John?
Stunning.
That's me.
That's my husband.
That's me.
Who? You can't really do these live shows without a partner. They're really tough to do. When you see someone doing a live by themselves, I honestly, like, my stomach kind of cramps for them because I know how much trouble they're having.
Yeah, and we didn't always start out with me talking. It was when we started doing the lives. And actually, I don't always talk on our pre-recorded.
No, you don't talk on our pre-recorded. Like, so if you see one of our VODs, they might be 30 minutes. The tutorial might be 30 minutes, and John doesn't talk. He's okay. Nothing happened to him. He's there. He doesn't... He's actually... People don't know this about John. He's super shy.
So...
And he's even shy that I just told y'all that he's shy.
You know, I have a job to do, so it's okay. But, you know, all that being there, I like doing the lives with you guys. It's like one of the more fun things for me to do. But now I forgot even.
You're just lost now.
I'm lost.
Lost in the messaging.
But see, that's the good thing is we can, you know, kind of, it's our show. We can
it's usually not this. Usually we're very business. Teach you to paint.
Yeah, but we're taking, you know,
we're celebrating today. You're invited to, this would be like if you lived in our town and we were having a 100K party. Mm-hmm. Hope you brought a good snack. I did.
Yes.
And we would invite you over to come celebrate with us because we wouldn't be here without you.
Not at all.
Like, not at all.
No. No, you can go back and look at, like, so one of our first videos and they were, I think that there's still the flavor of us. It's just different.
Yeah, like the part where you're like teasing me about how many times I put my brush to the canvas. I was just talking about that with Lisa.
Oh, yeah.
How many times I put my brush to the canvas and then didn't paint anything because I got on a soapbox.
Mm-hmm.
Then I have people now who send me soapboxes because they're like, she's on a soapbox all the time.
Judy's like, did John just tell her painting looks like a parrot live?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, I heckle her
live. He does. Doesn't bug me.
And see, now we're going to have to see if she can save it from being a parrot, which she may not. And then it'll be forever.
He's a very angry parrot if you save a parrot. Tell you that right now. He's a parrot you don't want to just roll up on and be like, hey, parrot.
It's a parrot of prey.
It's a parrot of prey.
It's a Romulan parrot.
Sorry. You're so funny.
Your hat's in the way of RoboCams. It's fine. I just...
My hat in the way of RoboCam. It's not a singing show. I just sing when I'm happy. And I'm happy today. It's been a long journey.
It's not a Technicolor parrot show either. We promise. It just...
You don't know that.
It could be.
You don't know what's in my imagination.
I don't.
You can't speak to the crazy that's percolating up here right now.
No.
I might do it. You know, I'm not limited in my art skills. There's no telling what could come in. Well, like, you probably know it's not going to have a race car, because I've said that before. I'm not really going to do a race car, but... You don't really know what I could be painting. I might surprise you. There we go. I'm using a glazing liquid. You're going to just kind of see, again, these are all art skills that you can do. You know.
I'm trying to get that yellow to not be so washed out.
These can be your art skills if you want them.
What yellow are you using there? It's really bright yellow.
This is Cad, and this is why I use pure Cad pigment. This is Cad Yellow Light.
Ah.
And this is Indian Yellow, and there's Cad Red Light, and I have Quinacridone. And I might have you get my Alizarin Crimson or my Naphthol from the table.
Yeah, that...
Because I'm feeling like I need a cool profile red as I'm going. This is really going to be an awesome painting. I'm kind of pumped about this. I feel like this need I might I'm this is like gonna be a thing. I'm like doing this for real. You're like, wait, what does that mean?
Let's see, I was just seeing there's a couple questions here.
I'm about to walk off and get a Alizarin Crimson.
Oh, sorry. Okay, there was a question.
I just don't want to panic you.
Okay, no, Pooh Bear has a question. I'll come back for Pooh Bear's question.
No, you can get the question. I'm just letting you know that I'm coming back.
Where's your painting at? What do you need?
I'm just gonna walk right there and get some. You don't have to get it. It's like the Naphthol Crimson or the other side of the table, all in a little pile, all the reds.
Okay.
Just bring me those two reds. Yep, just bring me those two and I'll make a decision. I'm sorry. I was willing to go get it. So you can see they're kind of close and they're sort of in the same profile. I think I'm going to do Naphthol. But I might get into the Alizarin for the Galaxy. And so you just, I'm going to put that out. And you can just see it's just slightly cooler than these two. And sometimes I like to cool up the reds. Be cool, red. Cool it up, man. Don't be cool. Don't be all uncool. That's right. Though you Real Housewife fans, I just quoted the Countess.
Now, are you driving this crazy train today, Cinnamon?
What, me?
Yeah.
In what way? Like I'm driving the painting?
I mean, like you is are you know how are we doing this today? Is this,
I don't
is
even
this,
know.
Is this your idea? Is this how did we get here?
I don't know how we got here. I'm still surprised we're at 100K. Are we really asking that?
I don't know.
Are you teasing me? What do you mean? I'm painting.
So how did we get here? We should tell that story.
How we got to 100K.
Well, why? Tell us. You can start with the beginning of the story of your Sherpa-dom.
Okay.
And we can start with you. How about this? We'll start with a few years ago, I was making video games and doing really cool video games up in Canada. And then I had a medical thing happen to me.
Crohn's.
Yeah, it was I had a pretty serious thing happen. And because of that, and a series of other things, I couldn't keep my job up in Canada. And so we ended up moving back down to Houston, and we moved down back to Houston in a much different way than we moved up. Because moving up, we had...
It's sort of the reverse of... who were they? The Beverly Hillbillies. It was the reverse of Beverly Hillbillies. Just rewind that whole show. Sorry.
So we went from, so it was a really interesting experience. We went to Canada with a whole lot of stuff, with like 18 wheelers full of stuff that we moved of our entire life. And then, because of this, you know, sort of catastrophic series of events, that sort of principally happened around my health, we lost a lot. We had to come back down to Houston, with a newborn kid. and
like just had this baby.
Just had new Luna was just born, and start looking for how to sort of restart. And we had a lot of family who came together around us and you know, helping us out. And so we ended up sort of getting reset into a little apartment. I was working on a couple little different game projects, looking at how to get some things together. And Cinnamon went out to start teaching painting parties, right?
An art skill. I'm going to take it on the road.
So you want to pick it up from there?
From the painting party. So
does that seem like a good place?
Well, I'll tell. So I was working one place.
Yeah.
We won't name it, but it was local.
Yeah.
And the guy there had really liked Bob Ross.
Yeah.
At some point.
Oh, they're all mad at me because I didn't finish the Gesso story.
Oh.
They're like,
welcome to our show.
Okay, we'll come back.
No,
to that
this
one.
Is we usually have we'll a play, guys. Yeah, there's usually back. Notes, so we have a plan, and this is not. Check out any other tutorial, you'll go, oh no, this is just a madhouse today.
Yeah, we'll come back to something.
We're being a madhouse today. That's
right.
Our plan.
So okay, keep going.
So I'm working at this place, right, and I'm just supposed to teach this guy's paintings to people. And they've got another guy there. And my mom was working at a place here, also in Houston.
Mm-hmm.
And her boss was very reluctant to allow a mother and daughter team in because he had feelings that mothers and daughters really fought, like cats and dogs.
Right. Not incorrect.
So we do, but not in the way he was thinking.
Right.
And you know, he wasn't interested, and then I was over there. But what you might not know about sipping paints is they really, really like to spy on each other.
Yes,
it's like
they
their
do.
Favorite thing to do. I'm not even kidding. Galleries like to do this, too. Galleries love to spy on each other.
Mm-hmm.
And so he got, you know, his little dark sunglasses on and came to see what was up, and he saw me there teaching.
Yeah.
And I don't know if it was him coming or what happened, but that made the guy I was working for uncomfortable. And so then I ended up, but then he was like, oh, you could probably teach her. So I ended up going over there to teach.
Right. So then I'll
we're you, really telling you the
you're
story.
You're telling a deep story. So you ended up going over there for a while and you ended up designing a lot of their top.
Well, like at first he wouldn't let me, I was like, I kept designing paintings and I was trying to help him with his social media and design some paintings and. You know, I'm kind of doing my, trying to, you know, kick my fine art over again.
Yeah.
Right? Because believe you me, you've got to hustle to make that work.
Yeah.
And I've been having babies. Which, you know, is not good on the CV.
No.
But awesome for life. All right. Can you guys see how I got a sunrise happening here?
Oh, let me back out of there.
Got the sunrise happening here.
There we go. Yeah, there is a sunrise over there.
It's not sucky, right?
So, Technicolor Parrot is turning into Sunrise Eagle.
Could be. Could
Interesting.
Happen.
Interesting.
Could be amazing.
We'll see.
It could be.
We're gonna remain quietly optimistic.
Be quietly optimistic. I might pull this out. You never know what I might do.
We're going to see. So, all right. So, then going on to our story. You're there painting there. And then you started having some remarkable stuff happen when you were teaching these.
So, I kind of thought I was going to come in and, you know... sort of teach ladies and maybe some guys that thought it'd be fun to paint recreationally and they'd just follow along and, you know, they'd have a little party and they would go.
Yep.
You know, kind of like a little art party. But while I was there, I found like a lot of people were having a different experience where they were really working out big stuff emotionally in their lives. And there was a lot more weeping than I had anticipated.
Yeah.
And I came to understand that people had their creativity taken away, that somewhere along the way, their just intrinsic right, which I'd grown up with, to be creative beings had been stolen from them by, you know, teachers or family members or something where they were told, you're not worthy of art.
What does that even mean?
I don't know, but I realized my whole life I'd been told I was worthy of art. I'd passed whatever test it was that...
Okay.
You had to pass to...
Genuinely. The one thing that still... I mean, you can really get me upset is when I hear someone being told by an art instructor that they should stop creating art because of some...
Happens all the time, too.
...judgy, high minded place that this person's coming from and just should stuff it up there, you know?
Yep. Because there's so many ways to be creative, and they're not all, you know, necessarily drawing based.
Right.
Drawing is not what makes you an artist. Drawing is a skill you learn.
It's just one of the things that happens along the way.
And you don't have to learn them in order necessarily.
You probably.
Oh, I hear some grief. By the way, if you ever wonder, do I get grief from art teachers about this? Yes. Yes, I do. They have feels.
No, we're not saying that there is not an advantage.
Bunch of great art teachers.
And even processes by which you, in schools of thought and processes to learn artwork. And if you're on one of those journeys,
that's awesome.
More power to you. And they're great and fantastic. But they are not the definitive.
They're just a way.
Right. They're not the only path.
There's
some
enjoy
of you
the path you're on.
Yeah. If you want to climb up the sheer face, go for it. If you're rappelling off the side, awesome. You know?
Well, and so that's how the art mountain, that's how the Sherpa ended up happening, is I was just trying to tell people, hey, it's going to be okay. I got you. Like, that nothing terrible would be happening today. Because we're just arting. It's going to be all right. We're just going to art a little bit, and then... you know, at the end, you're going to get a painting.
So there's a question back up here for
Pooh Bear. I'm on Sippy, I need to know. So my goodness. We are close, guys.
We are. And so Pooh Bear was – there were a whole bunch of questions coming in earlier, and Pooh Bear accidentally got timed out. It wasn't intentional. It was just like
a – Hi, Pooh Bear.
So Pooh Bear's question was do you have a certain type of paint to blend colors? He uses – or she uses the Simply brand. So do you –
What I'll tell you about Simply, and I painted with Simply, is that it's very economical and it is widely available. And you've got to keep in mind, you can paint with coffee grounds.
Yes.
I've done it. It is light on pigment. Batches are not always consistent in color.
Mm-hmm.
It can have binding issues. Those are just the challenges to your media. Everybody has challenges to their media.
It doesn't mean that there's anything wrong with them. You just got to understand how to work with them.
Yeah. If you're painting an encaustic, you're painting with hot wax. There's some challenges to that, but that doesn't mean you won't get a beautiful result. So never just feel bad about it.
Right.
I paint with professional paints, and I prefer certain brands. I have a little list of brands that I have had a lifelong relationship to, who have honored their customer service with me, who have consistently produced product that I can rely on, who, if for some reason I end up with a tube of paint that is not a consistency it should be, I could send them a picture and they'll refund or send me a new tube of paint. They address it in some way that respects me as a client. And so I've really come to love them. But wherever you are in the world, whatever paint you're with in the world, is just, you know, if you can do the color chart, if you make your own color chart and do some stability tests with the paint, because those are the two things you need to know. What colors does it mix and how stable is it?
Mm-hmm.
You address those two things, you can paint with mud. Yeah. Mud isn't very stable. You know that. How well does it mix? It mixes as well as mud. But you can still do some awesome paintings. How many people saw that share where I showed you those guys that painted in dirt on the back of a car window? Be aware. Just don't let it get in your head.
So I'm going to...
Don't let any artist ever shade you. Seriously. Don't let them do it.
Okay,
coffee.
So hold
on. No, I need
I'm going to come over.
Oh, a Twix? I'm gonna trade you.
I'm gonna double 400 you.
What? With Twix now?
We're double 400 on YouTube.
Double 400?
Mm.
Love you, YouTube.
Love you guys, YouTube.
Love you, Twix. Love you, Facebook. Love you. Oh, love you, Twix. Okay. Don't say that, Chris. Isn't she cute? Right. She's the first art puppy. She's the first puppy of art. Also known as Twix, Destroyer of Worlds. The natives are restless. Okay. So, you know, I'm in there and there's this lady and she's crying and we're dealing with tree branches. How many of you felt frustration about tree branches? And I'm just trying to explain, hey, you know, you haven't failed at life. This is just a short tree branch and we can elongate it. And here's some ways we can improve paint and flow. And there's just all this stuff. And I'm like in this, like, how can I express what it is I'm here to do, right? Because, like, some people come at art and they're like the art god, you know, and they're kind of like, oh, it's all about me. And I'm like, you know, but I've already gone out there and done my art thing. I'm like, what she needs to know is that I got her back. And I was like, who has your back? And art is just a set of steps. And all of a sudden it came to me, art's like a mountain. And it's going to make me cry.
Everyone was betting on how soon you cried.
And I was like, it's like I'm your art Sherpa. Yeah. And I'm going to guide you up this mountain one step at a time. So you don't have to worry about it. I know where all the steps go. You just have to take.
Yeah.
And so she and I had this whole moment, and there was like this hugging. And I realized like that people could paint just in general.
Mm-hmm.
They just needed people not, one, to be butts about it, and two, egomaniacs about it.
Yeah.
And just show them what the steps are, and they could learn these skills, and they could find their own way through and have their own creative voice, and that creative voices were valid. And they just needed to know that they had a guide, somebody just to help them out.
Yeah.
Which is a lot why it wasn't like painting with, and it was the Art Sherpa.
Right. That yeah. makes sense.
Yeah.
Because, you know, and so we, you know, you created this character.
Well, she's not a character. She's real. Profile. But it was like this idea of that. I'm loading my brush with soft body paint because I got to do galactic stars.
Yeah.
And I love the stars. That's my favorite part of a painting. Just not even lying to you here. Startup. So I started, you know, coming in and I was designing all these paintings and I realized I liked the designing process, even though the paintings were simple.
Mm-hmm.
And one day I came home and I it was after like a night where somebody had really resolved some stuff from childhood.
Right.
And I said, John, what if people couldn't afford a sip and paint?
Right.
What and if they couldn't afford
I
this?
Remember
what if
this.
They have no access to this? How could we help people? Because I bet people around the whole world feel like this. And so I was like, can you help me figure out how to get this out there? And we talked and John and I like kind of put our heads together and we're like, oh, you know what's free? YouTube's free.
Mm-hmm.
I bet that wouldn't be too hard.
Yeah, so we started looking at YouTube and well, we had a lot of, and
I bet anyone can just YouTube. It's for cat videos.
Well, we had looked at doing all sorts of stuff before. So we mm-hmm. had a little experience looking at video production from the video game side of things.
Yeah.
And kind of had some different ideas on how to approach this. And so we decided to go ahead and put together the YouTube channel. And it was, you started producing the videos.
Yeah.
And we didn't really know.
It was hard.
It was hard.
I'm going to hair dry. You okay. Tell them the next part about how hard it was because it was hard.
Yeah. It was hard. We didn't really know, like at first, what to do, right? Because we thought, hey, let's put out these videos. And we would put out a video and we would produce it. It took a lot of time and a lot of energy to make it. We didn't. You know, and Cinnamon was really passionate about, like, you know, she wanted to make it. And some of the early paintings we would do, and Cinnamon will tell you, there's still some of them that we never even completed because she would shoot it, I kid you not, 4 or 5 times with me. And it wasn't that she ever did anything to wrong. It was that some piece of equipment failed and something that I did went wrong and something, you know, it was just some technical challenge. And she was so committed to, I'm just telling them how, like, in early...
Have my eagle back?
Yeah, sure.
Can we safely do that? Because I know we're close here.
Yeah, yeah, I'll keep
we're, like, 18 away, which is just... I'm honestly freaking out in my head, but I'm just trying to be like, yeah, I'm chill, it's cool.
So I'll...
It's cool.
I'll
I'm chill. It's not a... But I'm not, like, actually feeling chill. I'm, like, freaking out. Just so y'all know.
And I'll see if I can get, then I can hit that button. Oh, there you go.
No, thank you.
So, and then as soon as we get close, I'll switch back over. So,
okay.
Let's go back to the story.
Okay, well, you were telling it about how hard it was to make it.
Yeah, so early on, when we first started shooting these videos, the first couple of them, and there's some
work.
Of them that never even made it to...
No, I painted this one tree branch. You will never see it.
Right.
It will never be on the channel or
and it
anywhere.
It had nothing to do with Cinnamon not doing it. She was able to make the recording every time. It was that we had some pit part of a technical failure, whether it was sound. Mostly it was sound. We would have camera angles that wouldn't be right. We would have some noise from the background that we would pick up or like we would have lighting that would change. Oh, my gosh. There were so many things that we had to learn about shooting.
Oh, it was a lot.
And so Cinnamon was such a trooper.
You were a trooper, too. Well, that was just hard.
You know, and it really made us clear about what parts of the show production we had to get in control of.
I even tried making those step-by-steps on Facebook.
Yeah.
Oh, when I first started, when I would first post, I couldn't even get my family members to like a post. If you ever feel alone on Facebook, I get your feels.
Yeah.
Because, so, dude, Sometimes it's hard to get people to acknowledge your art. It's just if they even see it, if the algorithm doesn't create some weird scenario where it just disappears into some ether.
Mm-hmm. So we ended up starting. You know, you started doing these videos, and we did them with about once a month because that was about or 2 months sometimes because we had a lot, you know, trying to reboot life, trying to figure out how to, you know, get on our feet, where our income was going to be coming from, how we were going to be doing all of this stuff. It was a big juggling act. And, you know, we ended up putting up videos, at first it was about once a month or every couple months. And then as we were able to start seeing that, you know, we were learning about our production cycle, figuring out how to be faster in our life about this, you know, how to bring it more center. And then also how to get better at producing things.
And we had some people that believed in us early on and helped us out.
And that was probably the biggest thing, is the people who believed in us and told us to keep doing it and like that this could, that we could go someplace with this.
And it would be meaningful and it would help people, and helping people was important. We had people that supported us in the idea that helping others was important.
And I think that early on, one of the things that helped us really solidify why we were doing this was our collection of stories.
The stuff you guys wrote in.
Yeah, the stuff that you guys wrote in. We would save up all the stories, and we still do, all the stories that you guys send in to us about, you know, the emotional journeys you've taken with our paintings and with us, and you know, how that's impacted you and your lives. And you know, that's been the real key driving force whenever we talk with partners and new people who are going to work with us, is that they understand our relationship to you guys and how important that is.
They don't get it. They got to go.
Yeah. That's the litmus test, is do they understand you guys? And if they don't,
then they got
to
go.
Yeah. And I think the brush guys are a good example of that.
Yeah. Everyone's like, how the brush guys in? Because they treated y'all well.
We found the brush guys through you guys. So, but we'll come back to them in the story later. Right. So we started producing these paintings. We were starting with more and more occurrence. And we started getting more feedback from you guys and getting better at it. And then Cinnamon came and was like, I want to make this happen. Like, let's put down everything else, set it all aside, and just focus on this, as scary as that is. You know? And it was at a time when we could just say, okay, let's...
take that risk.
Let's take that risk and do it. And... this last year has been about, you know, really making that that effort of growth, and I think that it's paid off. You know, this last year we've grown. You know, how much? You know,
I feel bad sometimes even saying a lot.
Yeah,
so much.
And you know, I just want to say thank you to all you guys. And I'm gonna bring up over here for you, Cinnamon, our counter, because. We're going to get close here.
Are we?
Yeah.
Let me know when I need to be looking. I'm trying to.
You want to turn around and look?
I don't know what y'all do, but I paint. Oh, my gosh. I paint when I'm nervous.
So.
Can you tell I paint when I'm nervous?
Yeah. I'm. I tell you what, I'm nervous. So. You know, I'm over here looking for.
You know, it was always John's dream to take this live.
It really was. I wanted to do this live with Cinnamon for so long.
He's like, live art would be amazing. And I'm like, man, I don't know anyone's going to care about live art. And he was like, no, they're going to love it. You want to paint live. They want to be there. And I'm like, okay.
You know.
See how he's starting to be. An eagle, but also a celestial being. You gotta love that space between.
Now I'm all over here looking for, it's like, where's all of our, I'm like getting all my music all ready.
You getting all your music already?
I'm trying to find some. I'm all like, what happened? My playlist's disappeared.
What happened to the stories?
So, okay, keep telling the story. So okay. I'm all distracted
so,
now.
So, yeah, no, we got started, and it was hard. And
So we started this last year really, really swinging the axe at this.
Well, it was, yeah, last year. And then yeah. I had a few friends that I had made on YouTube.
Mm-hmm.
And I thought it'd be really fun for us all to get together. I'd seen that Dear Me
mm-hmm.
On YouTube, and I thought, oh, that's a keyword that we can link together. We could use that feature that to create a kind of a video art festival.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
So I wrote some of my friends.
Uh-huh.
Some of you have been here this long know this. And I wrote some of my friends and said, hey, would you do this with me? And about 20 people that were like, yeah. And one of those friends, said that she was not willing to write everybody. that wasn't going to happen. But she'd make a video, and then we should all make a video, too. And that was Secret Soto.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Who was also the first YouTuber to reach out to me.
Yeah. And then you created the hashtag Love Summer Art event.
It was like 400 people.
That was crazy.
That was crazy.
That sort of launched the beginning of all of the...
Yeah, like right before VidCon.
Mm-hmm.
That was like wild.
And then we went to VidCon and we had all that great time meeting everybody there.
Uh-huh.
The first
and then
year.
I made a fool of myself with, you know, Zifrank. That was mm-hmm. fantastic. And so that was amazing.
And our second year at VidCon was really crazy.
You'll get some of this in a drama live or something, but
because you know our second year there, we were with all of the guys from the Lone Wolves, and Todd Graham was there, and
yeah, love VidCon. Stephanie Bergeron.
Stephanie Bergeron.
Well, I think
came.
She's going to be live on Facebook later.
Okay,
today.
You have to turn on look, Cinnamon. Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh!
I'm such an orc, but I don't care. Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god!
Thank you, guys. A long turn.
It's been really. Thank you. Thank you. I'm sorry. I'm happy. Sorry, it's a weird reaction. Oh, and then the shine is like going everywhere. I'm looking like the Tin Man over here.
Yeah. So you just put all the bubbles up there so that...
That's amazing. Thank you. Seriously, I can't tell you how many people told us no. We were the first with this format. And everybody said it was stupid.
Yeah.
Except you guys.
So thank you.
We wouldn't have done it without you. Everybody was like, make them 3 minutes and not multi-camera and don't be weird.
Yeah, don't talk to people.
Don't talk to people. Stop talking.
Make it shorter. Everything that we did, we were told we were doing it wrong. And maybe we are still doing it wrong, but thank you guys for being here with us while we're doing it wrong because we wouldn't have it any other way. You know?
Oh, no. Just having a moment.
So, you know... This is really about thank you, I guess, is ultimately what we can't say enough.
Thank you.
You know, because this is...
I couldn't have done it without you. There's just no way to put that in context. There's no YouTuber that does it without their community. I know every YouTuber I've ever talked to, whether they have 20 members in their community or 7 million members in their community, they know that they're literally there only because of you guys. Like, only. He's the only reason. Yeah. So, this is that one place where artists and their communities can be together. And Twitch and Facebook, thank you. I know that a lot of this was you today. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you for my bubbles. They're my whoopee. The bubbles coming out, I'll be like upset in the studio. And I was like, bubbles. And I'm like, I feel better.
But it's, you know, it's
oh my goodness.
It's been a big emotional journey for us. And you know, you guys can only, yeah, I'm sure you can understand and relate that you know, there's so much of this that happens all at once, and we know that that this is a big deal for us, and we just kind of we're glad that you guys are here to take a moment with us and share.
Thank you.
You know, because oftentimes you don't take enough time to remember why you're doing things and celebrate
why
those
you started.
Moments. And we're really fortunate that today at 2 o'clock on a Monday, we're you know, on Martin Luther King Day, which is kind of awesome. So it's we have a holiday.
It's really awesome
that we get to celebrate our 100,000 subscriber count with you guys on YouTube, and you know, it's we're just very blessed to be here, and
yeah, we are very blessed to be here,
even with our Technicolor parrot.
You just keep talking. He's really tough to play card games with, just so y'all know. He just talks a lot of nonsense. Talks a lot of nonsense, this one.
So, yeah. Gosh, babe. So, yeah, we're a little quiet here. We're a little introspective about this journey that we've been on with you guys. And it's you
this
know.
This is a little inside baseball. But on Weeping, do you remember when we went to Content Lab? Content Lab.
Oh man, Content Lab.
If you guys
are
not
so much
YouTubers,
fun.
Is this weird thing that when you've been, you know, you have a few more subscribers, they make you come in and without make you, they give you this for free.
They make
it's an
you,
opportunity. They give you this chance to come in and do some more training and do this thing called Content Lab. If you have a channel over 10,000 subs, please go to every Content Lab.
Yeah.
Anywho, so one of the things that we do is we have to. It, you know, kind of let other people review our channel.
Oh, yeah.
And this very sweet makeup maven was reviewing my channel, and it was right after Orlando. And so that's the last video that was up there, and she watches it for a while, and she's all quiet and serious, and she's like, listen, I think you have a very good show, but it would be better if you cried less. I was like, oh, okay.
You don't cry in all of them. Like, just in
just
a couple.
Just the one where a bunch of people died. But yeah, okay.
Or we cross 100,000.
Or we cross 100,000.
But, you know, the what I will say is that...
just that girl was so funny. Oh, okay.
And, you know, I'm going to look over here because it was a really great comment here. Oh. I'm going to go find it. It was... Someone, oh.
We'll be doing this with you soon, Twitch. You hang with us.
Ida says, you
we'll
know,
be balling over there as well.
You know, that we're a good example of what can happen when you follow your dreams. And I will totally say thank you to all of you because it's true.
That's what we should name this painting.
What's that?
Is Follow Your Dreams.
Follow Your Dreams. There you go. There we go.
Totally name it Follow Your Dream.
So.
I'm just painting today.
There's your.
You're now kidnapped into my studio. This
bubble
is,
relief.
I'm okay.
It's okay.
I'm okay.
There's no crying in painting.
Dude, there's so much crying in art. There's crying and dancing, and there's crying in art. Can I have my eagle back?
You can have your ass. Totally. Let me get your.
I need my eagle back. Do you use a reference photo? Yes, because I'd like to paint well.
Let's see here. Where'd you go? There you are. And I'll see if I can get your reference photo back up there.
Thank you. I'm really proud of him.
I think he looks great.
I really like him. He should be a shirt or something.
We can do that.
I know.
Okay, hold on. I have buttons I'm pushing.
You do?
Bang! Did it work? Oh, it did. Look.
Okay, cool.
Okay, we got reference back.
Just making sure that.
There we go. It. That's the button you want to be on. Okay, so Technicolor Parrot is turning less Technicolor and less parody.
You know, I'm going to call it Follow Your Dreams, and then everyone else now is going to call it the Technicolor Parrot. Which they should do. I think if, you know, and again, if you haven't painted with me before, know that when we do lessons, we explain everything.
Yeah.
And this is in you. This is just layers. These are just the spaces. Now, the weird part of me that says, when I see that eagle picture, that says I need to have the sun here and space here, mm-hmm. that is the me.
Ah, okay. So the
in the painting,
I've been not
you're,
getting.
So you might be different.
I've been neglecting some of my chat here with some of the button pushing.
Oh, chat away. I need to we're come just over, going along.
They need me to come over and give you a hug from the community because they love you so much and they see the kiss that you're. You're having some cries, and they
I
want
am.
To give you some
it's
hugs.
Just been, you know, man, it's been, whew. Oh, my God. You want to see me cry? Wait till the button gets here.
I love you. Thank you.
I know y'all didn't kiss me. That was him. So I just don't want it to get weird between us. Oh, this is such a great look. Hey, how not to do your makeup. I really like my lipstick, though.
We'll have to get a makeup maven to come in and do some makeup for you.
Yeah, I need it. I need Willem to come in. I need Willem. Somebody get Willem.
Somehow, I don't think that's community compatible.
It may not be, but I'm just sure I would look fierce. And really good. And I'm willing to put glue and tape.
All right.
Okay.
So
lipstick is on. We're recovering. Putting our big girl panties on. Big girl panties. Right?
Mm-hmm. Oh, I gotta see where you're at.
Oh, I'm just adding some
Rebel cam.
Fire to the wing.
Oh. So that's why there was so many colors on there.
What? Oh, yeah. So that I can make a seamless transition on him through his two states.
Interesting.
If Daenerys had an eagle, this would be him. Khaleesi is coming to Westeros.
That's looking pretty cool. I actually like this quite a bit now.
The scarier version of Pepe. I do less sit on your head and more pick out your eye. I really like this music, which is just so sad because you know that's because of the 80s right there. Just trying to get his highlight. The point, I have to focus things slightly tightly around his face before I finish out the sky effect. Otherwise, the piece just won't resolve or gel.
Yeah.
And that's what's going on here. And so, it's a little bit slower in its process, but it's just, there's nothing to do but do it.
Nothing to do but the doing.
Nothing to do but the doing. Nothing to do but the doing.
Oh, so they want a Follow Your Dreams t-shirt, for sure.
Okay, cool.
So, and I like it as maybe a mug, because I drink a lot of coffee.
You do.
Which I shouldn't
I do too. What am I even I'm saying? Not, like, I'm, like, I'm not like the coffee is like the one, yeller right here.
Yeah, coffee's the one thing that I drink that I'm not supposed to. And I'm pretty good about, I don't eat much meat. I don't, eat anything processed. There's, no dairy that's not super organic, raw, natural goat cheese, something weird.
Right.
But man, coffee gets me.
It does every time. It calls to you.
Feel the need for the caffeine.
Calls you in and you were good. And then what happens every time?
As long as I only have one cup of coffee, nothing.
You know what is bad when you cry? You don't see as well. There's an art tip. Really, really diminishes your art eyesight to be weepy. And then I have that dry eye thing.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm supposed to be taking these incredibly overpriced eye drops, which we don't do because they're kidding, right? It's just sometimes I get to the pharmacist and I just feel this is just a joke we're all having with each other, right? Definitely needs to have a spark off that, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm seeing that happen right now.
So, that's interesting. Marilyn was asking, what is the big silver button? That's an interesting question.
So, for reasons I don't know why they started doing it, YouTube awards you plaques. Gives you little awards of you did a good job.
Yep.
And they give you a button at 100,000, which is a silver button. It's a silver play button. And then they... I just took out my mic.
No, you're fine.
No, no.
I hear it. I can still... Oh, okay. I see what you're saying.
And then they give you one at a million. And then they give you... After that, it's a diamond. And I think there's a ruby after that. I don't really expect to get to diamond or ruby, but I would love to get to a gold play button. It is a dream. He's a dream, but honestly, the silver play button was a dream. These are journeys. These are real journeys. It's so hard to get your, you know, I just know so many amazing artists, you know, just trying to get their artwork seen on the platform. It's really hard. There's something like, they say 400, I think it's like 600 hours uploaded every minute of new video every day. It's very hard to be seen. And the process of getting seen, it's that's its own. Okay, I just made him real stern there.
Super stern.
He's not even playing. Space Eagle. Space Eagle says no.
Galaxy. Yeah, Galaxy Eagle says I'm not a parrot.
He is. He's looking right at you, John. He's like not even enjoying your nonsense in any way.
Now, how did you make him look so stern? I guess you brought that brow down over that.
I did. I created a drop to his brow, and I added, and I think this is very important. I always add, I get a lot of compliments on my eyes, but one of the things I always do is I add a shadow from the lid.
Gotcha.
You need a shadow. Otherwise, what? What is it?
What?
I don't know.
What is it?
Shadows.
You know.
Give him more of a birdie nostril. All the bird people are like, oh, thank you.
Now we've got, just so you know, we've had over 425 people with us out here
on
YouTube.
That is amazing. Hang in, though. This is about to get cool.
Okay.
Not you, though.
Okay.
You're good.
I'm hanging in. I'm not going anywhere.
Yeah, you're stuck.
You got me. And I think we've got like 180-something people over on Facebook. And then,
wow.
Like, you know.
Thank you guys so much. Thank you for being part of this.
And on Twitch, we've got like 21 people.
21 people.
Which is, you know.
I'm going to put out some zinc white.
Good for Twitch, I think.
See, if you guys took the Big Art Quest was this weekly kind of like just explain everything in the art store and the basic art processes weekly series that we did for free.
Mm-hmm.
So you would know exactly why zinc white would be pulled out right now. Many of you are like, I know why. I know why. I'm so excited.
Why are you excited?
Well, they know why.
Oh, yeah, that's true. They do. Oh, hey, what was that? What are you doing with that?
I have to do some, you know, this isn't dramatic enough up top. It needs some drama, doesn't it, guys?
Some drama.
Drama, drama.
Okay,
drama,
so
drama,
Freckle
drama.
Red would like to know, they're saying, so Freckle Red would like to know what kind of
Freckle
lipstick.
Freckle Red, you do the best comments.
What kind of lipstick
everywhere,
are you
Instagram, here, you do the best comments.
What lipstick are you wearing?
I am wearing Urban Decay's Asphyxia. And there is a link in the description because I met y'all and I knew you were going to ask. And I think some of our moderators have the link. But it's limited edition. And I got this one on sale today. I had to get some new makeup, which clearly was pointless. And and so I got this because I was like, ooh. I really like it. And it's very hard to get like a really dramatic purple that you can daylight with. I mean, not that I should, but I just do. Because, I mean... If not now, when?
Mm-hmm.
Right? If not now, when purple hair? People are like, yeah, in college. No, I did that then too.
Oop, I gotta slide over there.
But there just can't be an end to fun, right?
No. Not at all.
So I'm just adding this little cloud here. Just trying to give this little feeling of the clouds that would be circling the sun. The nice thing about the zinc white is that it's not as intensely bright
mm-hmm.
as the titanium, and it's a little bit translucent, so it allows the paint underneath to show. So it makes easy work of that cloud feeling, doesn't it? Look
yeah.
at that. Look how easy that is.
Oh.
Oh. Oh, I love that.
Okay, so Bethany's like, John, finish the black gesso story. Good, thank you for the reminder. Okay, so.
Thank you for the reminder.
Cinnamon was getting coffee earlier, as we were saying. And I was here and I was gessoing this canvas black. And so the Cinnamon has a habit of not closing the bottle tops all the way. So that allows a little skin to form on the bottle top. So I tend to go back behind them and have to clean out all the bottle tops. And so the caps will close properly. But in this case, I didn't notice that this had happened. So just flipped it open, flipped the bottle over and squeezed it. And it nothing came out. And then I was like, so I shook the bottle a little bit, looked at the end, poked the top, flipped it back over and squeezed it again. And then it exploded.
All over the new painting.
All over this painting and the one next to it, which was...
You guys haven't seen it yet.
And it was just black gesso apocalypse everywhere. It was completely covered in black gesso. And so I immediately just picked it up, ran into the kitchen, knowing that we use a pro paint, and it had been cured for several days. And I just stuck the entire board under the kitchen sink and just washed it off. Just used my hand and scrubbed it off lightly until I got all the gesso off. And then as soon as I got all the black gesso off, I immediately went over and lightly dabbed it with a towel. Now, I'm not advocating this as a way of solving it. I'm saying based on experience, I thought it would survive. And sure enough, when I came back out, no paint had lifted. It was just perfect.
He was so excited.
I was like, yeah, propane. And it was, you know, good pro paint when it's cured won't lift. It seals pretty good. And you know, that's not 100% true 100% of the time, but I would say it's 99.99% true in pro paint across the board. So that's why we use pro paint in our studios. And so I'm going to make
it. You were so excited. You were like, I didn't destroy your painting. I'm like, oh. Oh, that's nice. Thank you. Not destroying my painting today. Thank you.
I was pretty, you know, I was pretty confident, you know, that even when it had happened, I was like, you know, because I know what happens to the paintings just in our studio by accident all the time, you know. Daniel's like, John, can you paint? Not unless it's using a spray can.
He can.
You know, I've learned a lot watching, but I like no brush skills at all.
He has some. He had to be in the art department.
Well, I took art history. I've taken art history.
Took pottery with me.
And I've taken many sculpture courses and foundry and things like that. But not, I mean, to be honest, I was always intimidated by color mixing. And so that stopped me from really pursuing painting. And I just, you know, it didn't seem
your
like...
Your mom hangs all your stuff.
Well, yeah, but I mean, this isn't how I wanted to express my artistic self. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's like...
This is just one thing.
Yeah.
It's not that this is bad.
Well, I like music. You know?
He's a really good drummer. Pretty decent horn blower.
Yeah, I like that. I like this. I like doing live. I like the whole process of our live performances. You know, I really enjoy the building of our community experiences. I find that very artistically fulfilling. You know, like when we work on the website and we're able to get a new thing working or, you know, put together a new project that's fun for everybody. That's a lot, I think, where I get fulfilled. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So,
and I think it's like important to realize that there's a group of people making this all work.
Mm-hmm.
Just, you know, from moderators to community volunteers to our community manager, Flame Gremlin, to John and I working full time. And we do work the full time.
I'm going to zoom out here and take a look at that a little bit.
All right. Is it looking cool?
That looks pretty cool. I like Stern Technicolor Parrot.
He's got some good parroting styles.
We've officially crossed from parrot to angry to
Iron
Eagle.
He's all full eagle now.
He's full eagle
now. He doesn't even feel your shade anymore. He's like, come on, man, bring it. Because I got nothing for you, dude.
There's nothing but galaxy beneath my wings.
I feel like I've got to put something in here for Patricia, so I'm trying to set it up where I can do that.
It feels like there's a threadbanger, like...
Don't you guys think that Rob and Corinne should totally watch my show?
Back in the day, we thought that they were the king and queen of
YouTube. Are the king and queen. He's still king and queen of YouTube. Who else?
Yeah.
No vloggers or anything. It's Rob and Corinne all the way.
It's like we have that, I don't know, I think it was the Fun Guy video where I put that stuff in there about them. But we, for a long time, really thought that would be cool. And this is sort of the galaxy beneath my wings. And so that's a little shout out there to Rob.
They don't know us at all. Like, I'm sure they're the sweetest people in the world, but it's not like they would cross the VidCon floor to say.
But someday, Rob, you'll get to know that you're the galaxy beneath my wings.
You're at least the donut in the waffle iron, I'll tell that right now.
That's right. You know, we definitely have donuts in the waffle iron in the window for you. So you ever come by the studio, you know, we got it covered.
We're going to do something super cool here for Patricia.
Oh, yeah?
Yep.
What are we going to do there?
Can't know yet.
Okay.
It's a surprise.
Oh, man, I got to catch up on the...
Hmm?
What brush are you using on the clouds?
Okay, so I really wish I could tell y'all about this brush. This is an experimental brush.
It's a prototyping brush.
It's a prototype.
So,
I try not to pull it out too much on our tutorials because it's awesome, though, isn't it, y'all?
Stay tuned for more information about this brush
and
other announcements later.
Later. Go come around here. I'm just trying to think of kind of galaxies and things that I've seen. Galaxies I've seen along the way. Galaxies are so interesting, aren't they?
Mm-hmm.
They're interesting. Very, very interesting.
I like it.
Seriously, I could be like on any of those like shows where you have like 3 days to like make something. And I would be like their go-to painter. Like, no, I paint that all.
Yes.
I paint that too.
So,
I would not be getting any shade from the judges. I'll tell
like,
you that
right now. But wait, what is that brush? This is a prototype brush that we are testing to work on. We're working on some brush stuff. You guys have always known we're searching for the new brushes that are going to be the Sherpa home. And this is one of those research projects that is going very, very well. And
I'm really into testing my stuff.
We're going to make sure that before we release anything that we know it works and will meet the demand of our Sherpa community and that we'll have the support and longevity that we're going to expect of a product. So we're testing them fully. And so you'll see some more of that. And much like we're gonna keep it super secret on
super secret.
But you'll get to see them in action. You'll get to see them in action. But we're not gonna have them available quite yet. I can't see what you're doing there. You
can't. I'm thinking.
Oh, okay, you're thinking. Because I was like, where did she go? She's between canvases. I can't. So.
I'm just trying to think what I want. I'm just right now because I'm not using references for this. I just offloaded paint on my easel and sometimes it's not so dirty.
So
there are bad habits I resist participating in when I'm teaching.
Which is just wiping paint on your easel?
Yeah.
So Stan's like, you better ship... Okay, so there's a bunch of people asking questions about brushes in there.
Sure, I'm happy to answer any questions about brushes. Because I think just understanding what makes a good brush will get you really far.
Well, I think that these are more specific about our community.
Okay.
So what I'll say is to answer them in general, when as soon as we can, we will announce details about our brush projects. Right now, we are actively researching and working with, we're working on our design and trying to settle in on, oops, there we go.
Right partners.
The right partners and being able to talk about those partners and making sure that everything is in order for that to happen. So... And you'll see much more of that happening soon. We will make sure that whatever we do, we'll be able to ship worldwide. you know, the, the brush guys have long been a big supporter and advocate of us. And they ship worldwide. They make sure that our community's been taken care of. They have the discount code, TheArtSherpa, so you can get 5% off your orders there. And Jeff and Dave are fantastic guys. So they've and whatever we do, you know, Jeff and Dave, they'll make sure that they're going to be able to carry those and work with us in that partnership. So,
nothing's
going to sneak up on you guys. Don't worry. We're as soon as we can talk more about
it. Yeah, and it will be available widely.
Widely.
To anyone that wants one.
Worldwide. Well, that's one of the big criteria.
Not limited. Mm-mm. No.
So, you know, it's so stay tuned. I would say that this month there's probably going to be more to say about that.
Hopefully.
And more. Some more other stuff, too. So, but we've learned to try to be more careful. Because it's like, we'll say, guess what we're going to do? And then it's like, uh-oh.
Something happened. Something so outside of our control happened. And then we're that wasn't even our fault, man.
What are we supposed to do now? And we're like, man, we got to tell them. So we've stopped doing that.
Yeah. Theoretically.
Except you just caught us in the act.
Doing
it right now, where you weren't supposed to see the prototype.
No, I have to use the prototype because this is like my favorite one right now to use. I don't want to have to do it without it.
Where are you at?
Other things, but I'm just trying to create some space.
Will they be available at stores, Wetzel? You can bet it. We're gonna have store somewhere. Plan is stores near you. We hope. Stores near you.
You know, well, we have what we want in our mind, and you know, if it's that, then it's that, and that's all we're doing.
Yeah, we're gonna take time to make sure
no rush, and
yeah,
make sure it's right.
But it is coming. It's fun. It's okay. Let's move on to less.
You guess like less what?
We can't keep dwelling on this.
We can't. It's hard not to.
Yeah, I know. So what else do we have going on?
We want to invite them into morning conversations that they can't be part of. I think I'm doing pretty good about like pulling like nebula from my mind.
Mm-hmm.
I think so.
And so now you're just.
I
noticed you're painting
a
nebula
here underneath
the wings. I'm trying
to decide if I feel planetary.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I might be planetary right here.
I would kind of like to see something planetary.
Would you like to see something? I'm kind of feeling some planetary stuff. And then there's this big event that needs to happen right here. So I guess a lot of this, to weight him here, I got to put some stuff here so he's kind of balanced.
And the twinkle stars. They want.
Yeah, we're
going to
twinkle a star.
Twinkle stars.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star. How the Sherpa wonders where you are. I just like doing it. When I'm teaching a lesson, you know, I'm cooking. Y'all know the speed. You know the pace.
And we're going to say hi to all of our little brushes out there. The ones from London, the ones from Australia, the ones from Sweden, the ones from Canada.
Wherever you're from. That one guy that keeps signing in from the Congo and signing out.
Okay, definitely.
Are you okay, guy from the Congo? Oh, and you know who else I want to thank?
Who?
Our committed trolls.
Oh, yeah. And you know, okay.
Who make every video. We think about you. We worry about you. We hope you're having a really good 2017. Take care of yourselves. Eat well. Get plenty
Belgium,
of rest.
Belgium, Germany. Oh, my
we
gosh.
We wouldn't
thank
be real YouTubers without you.
We have 600 likes on YouTube right now. So
and our 600 likes.
Whoop. Oh, gosh. Whoop. Thank you. And someone called it that this is a Beastie Boys painting because it's now intergalactic planetary.
Oh, see, I have respect for you right now.
Yes.
Whoever said that? Mad respect.
Mm-hmm.
Do you like how my galaxy?
Would
Jack Black say yeah? Don't y'all think Jack Black should paint with us?
That'd be awesome. He should sing with us while we paint.
Somebody else should do the singing because Lord knows it shouldn't be me. But you know what? If you have a song in your heart, just sing it. Just sing it. That's what I learned from The Sound of Music. That's what Julie Andrews taught me.
Wow, there's over 600 likes here on YouTube.
I'm digging this piece. I'm just kidnapping y'all just watching me. But I'll teach you how to do it. I have you can find the whole. There's a playlist for space on the YouTube channel for free. A bunch of galaxies to take you through all the different ways you can create aurora borealis, things that are galaxified, galaxy wolves, galaxy. galaxies, black light galaxies. That's right. Would you like to have a black light painting party with your friends?
And this is actually, we've clicked, I mean, for all the delay, you know, all the slowness of our hugging and kissing and celebrating, mm-hmm. and you
really?
Know, we're only an hour and a half into this.
I'm trying to set the size of my planet. Hold on a second, guys. Right. I'm looking for some stuff.
Don't where'd the Sherpa go?
Where'd the Sherpa go?
Sherpa's gone. I'm gonna look at this painting because it looks pretty cool.
It's a pretty cool painting. I'm just trying to get these shavings out of this jar. And
what are you
I'm
doing?
Supposed to I'm just trying to compare space. I think this is a good but ooh, should we be like this? How big do we want the planet? I guess is our decision.
I don't know. Some planetary. Okay, that looks good, I guess.
We could go that big. I may not have a spray can, but I can paint you some space. With some bubbles and some hot jazz and Caravan Palace, except that we get pulled off of Twitch and Facebook.
And YouTube.
And YouTube. I think Caravan Palace should just let us play their music, because we've got to be selling a bunch of it.
Mm-hmm.
Don't you think?
I do.
See, and then I think, what do you think about having another planet, like, right there?
Ooh, that'd be cool.
Like a sister planet. What's the size of, I guess, pretty substantial, right?
Yeah.
All right, Riddick. This is a new planet for you to escape from.
I love this. I love the painting so far. It's looking
do
very
you?
Cool. Yes.
I'm pretty happy. So,
oh, and Patricia wants to do this for her husband.
Well, Patricia, there's going to be a special tribute in there for you and your husband up here. Because I don't know how long the other thing we talked about will take, so I'm going to make sure that special thing you asked for is going to be present. And Patricia just went, oh, really? And I'm saying, yeah, really, Patricia. That's really, really happening.
Really, really?
Really, really, really.
Oh, cool. I don't
know. Really, really, really.
I don't know really, what's happening. Is there a traceable really, of the eagle?
Huh?
Is there a traceable of this?
There is not yet, because now I have to add some stuff.
But you'll do a traceable.
But I'm going to do a traceable.
And then we'll put it up in all the places.
We'll put it up in all the places. Plus, you can use the reference photo, too.
That just reminds me. I can do this. Where's one of the places? TheArtSherpa.com.
TheArtSherpa.com.
You can go to that place. And you can check out. There's a link to the traceables.
Mm-hmm.
There's a link to, there's our chat there. You can find a link to our store, which is shop.theartsherpa.com.
Yeah, you know.
And you can, I'll take it away. My gratuitous plug machine. Book. And then I'll bring back this. Book. Book. There it goes. And come hang out with us there, because that's where we have all that stuff to do. And share. And don't forget to share us. So if you're here, you should, we already have like a billion
tomorrow
likes.
We're going to do just a regular lesson.
Are we?
Yeah, it'll be about, like an hour long.
Yeah. This one.
I'll show you how to paint a candle. Because this weekend we have a very special tribute coming up to firemen. So this is a good time to do any of the fire-focused paintings that we have.
Yeah. Now, you think
because we're going to do a very special tribute to firemen. And no, it's not going to be the towers. It's going to be a tribute to the pieces based on that moment when the fireman, hits that ultimate heroism.
Yeah.
Right? And so I think y'all are going to like it.
Gotcha. So the...
I can't do that other thing. You guys ask me. I cry every time. You think I cry at 100,000, you should... You can't believe how much I cry over that.
Where are you going? Okay.
I'm just trying to... So what I got to do here, whenever you're painting a planet in space...
Uh-huh.
Whenever you're painting a planet in space, whenever you give a dog a donut, you ask your husband to go get you the color green.
Yeah.
Phthalo green. Could you grab it for me? I went... Deeper into colors, I can go get it.
Oh, yeah, okay, I'll get it. Here's a second.
I swear it's not passive aggressive. It's just that when I walk over, he's like always like, don't walk off stage. Just phthalo green.
Phthalo green?
Yeah. It should be in one of those rows. And he gets like freaked out like a walk off. And so he's like, don't walk off. So that's what's actually happening. It's not at all power play or anything. It's just because I know later he'll be like, you walked off. And I'm like, yeah, but you were... switching and
yeah,
I don't know if y'all been married a long time, you get what we're talking about. You get what we're talking about. This is the craziest thing. I have done 1 5-hour paint, which was a whole lesson, like I taught the whole time to do Le Belle Dame Merci, and that's on, and we've done the dragon. This is more kind of like, hey, look what you can do with your art, which is also cool.
Yes.
Because you can do some cool stuff with your art. I'm going to get this one back out. I got to make sure this, because I don't have another. The experimental brush is the only brush I have. I love experimental brush. Please work out. Anywho. Because otherwise, these will become like the biggest brush spa contenders.
Which one?
The experimentals.
Yes, the experimentals are pretty good.
So, what you want to do is you want to make sure that you're shading your orb. Because planets are basically circles. And you have a light source here. Where would the shadow be? Right there. And then, of course, this planet would make a shadow next to its friend. And why they're not destroying each other, I don't know.
But that's okay.
Should.
This is intergalactic planetary.
Intergalactic
planetary. Now, there's a question here. When are we going to be doing the stained glass grapes?
Really soon.
Yes?
Yeah, we got to get those in the can. We had them in the can, and stuff went wrong with the can.
Yes.
Which is very upsetting.
We'll be getting.
And then we gotta stay caught up on all our current filming, and then go back and like refilm. So we've got a deer that's mm-hmm. in that situation right now.
That was the one that I accidentally re-rescued today.
Ah.
So, that was one that got hit by the the black gesso of doom.
Stressful times.
So, what time tomorrow are we gonna go back live?
11 a.m. Okay. We're gonna do it in this manner, so we can't promo it. Interestingly enough.
Mm-hmm.
The way we had been doing them before. Because they have to be on the live now
mm-hmm.
for it to work this way so everybody everywhere can have access to it.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And the reason we bother with Facebook is Facebook has connectivity longer than any other platform.
Yeah.
Which means if you need art in a particular place. And then also, if you're having data issues, check out Amazon because we have some videos there. If you have a friend.
Oh, that's right. We do. We have some. And we have more that are coming out as soon as we can.
Yeah. A bunch of stuff happening on Amazon. So you can, with Prime, you can just download them.
Mm-hmm.
And if you're in an area that doesn't have that, we have like the least expensive allowed.
Right.
Download fee. And it does go to us. So that's nice. Just think of it like, oh.
And the real goal there was that we had a lot of folks that were saying they wanted to be able to take the videos with them, you know, and download them and take them places.
Mm-hmm.
So this was the best way for those who didn't have like good high speed internet, or they could go to like a Starbucks, or they could go to their friend's house, download the videos, and then bring them home.
Yeah.
And we try to make that as super easy and as possible.
We did.
And that brought us to here.
What were we thinking?
Now, how many hoots do you think this is, given our journey so far?
I think this is a three-hoot painting.
Yeah?
But I think anybody who's comfortable in a three-hoot space, if you've done luminary or any of the landscapes, this would just be that. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. A lot of you are at a place where even seeing the picture now, you can do it.
Yeah.
You know, and that's okay. But I appreciate the watch time today. We just felt like we had to do something sort of special to celebrate.
Mm-hmm.
No, I don't want to get content ID. I don't know why I think I'm going to sing well enough today to get it, but it could happen. And then I'll feel silly, doofusy.
Well, they're going to hold my feet to the fire to make me come out and dance because.
Love it.
At 100,000, they feel like they're deserved of a real dance.
I think they are deserved of real John Cooney.
I don't know
style moves.
I don't have any.
I feel like that is the truest thing I ever heard in my life.
I think we almost have to have like I don't dance, so I mean like this is just, you know. Napoleon Dynamite time, but
actually he could really dance. Remember the movie?
Yeah, I know.
You gotta start staying awake for these things.
But you know, it's in that level of awkwardness. So
I live there.
Yeah,
that's my life. Woohoo for the awkward people!
For the intergalactic planetary people.
Awkward people. I'm an awkward person. Just making sure I get my...
Do the Macarena. I think I might actually know that one.
Just having... I like doing planets because they're like little abstract marbles or balls.
I love how this one's coming together. The little swirlies. I guess I can take down the...
Yeah.
You don't need him anymore.
Yeah, the eagle is the eagle has landed. Sorry. <Da-da-tsh. laughs> Yes, so bad, isn't it?
I love how it's coming together, though. Hmm? It looks so good how it's coming together.
Does it? It's nice, thank you.
Kimmy Berry's like, yes, dance, John. I'm like, oh man. I'm pushing buttons. I'll be back over later. See, look, me distract you with some bubbles.
Look, a button.
Do 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 bubbles.
You're trying to distract them with bubbles or me?
Everyone.
Oh, because you're going to dance.
No. Well, yes, but, you know.
But you just don't want them to know you're going to dance?
Well, I don't, maybe we could.
Probably not announcing it first will help.
Well, they're, it's not like they're going to let me not get by.
I really don't think they are. I think you've owed people a long time.
Oh, where's the button? But we're just waiting to see how your planets are coming
together. I don't
know.
I'm just making it up.
I like
I'm
your
just planets. Feeling it out. I'm like, this is my planet, and right now I'm just making some weather pattern decisions.
Camera was like, it was like, squirrel bubbles.
I just want to have some weather pattern decisions happening here.
So who lives? Do all the cosmic parrots, I mean eagles, live on this planet?
You just are asking for it, Mr. Cooney, and I'll tell you that right now. Just with your smarty, smarty mouth.
I love it.
It just needs to, you know, have some sky. You gotta have sky and air and breathing and growing. And we haven't even... we haven't even...
Now, tomorrow, what time are we gonna be live?
11 a.m.
11 a.m. Okay, guys.
And I'm gonna be teaching you how to paint a really cool melty candle.
Ooh.
Because, you know, you need to know how to paint a melty candle for... I don't know what reason, but it'll go really nice in your kitchen.
For strategic role-playing game purposes.
Or in your wine room, I guess, is my plan.
It's strategic role-playing game purposes.
But, you know, maybe you want to hang it in your bathroom. So, no, I'm not judging.
Or your gaming room.
Or your gaming room. It could be a very good gaming one. I almost added D&D dice to it.
I'm gonna make it more accessible than that, but yeah.
So, Luke was having a question.
Luke.
And his question was, sometimes I lack the confidence to do certain paintings. Is there any advice that you could give to carry on as I sometimes scrap paintings? Oh, well, I would say don't scrap the painting.
Yeah.
Gotta. So why don't you talk about that middle phase that you
have
so much?
I mean, we all have that. So, you know what I mean? Like, I know some very established, successful artists, and they run into that moment. There's always a painting or an art challenge that any of us can run into that is overwhelming, and when we first attempt it, is likely to not give us a result that we're particularly satisfied with. Mm-hmm. And I find that the difference between the pile of artists that succeed at these things and the ones that are stuck are the difference between the artists that just go, you know, I accept the suck.
You accept the suck.
I accept it. It's happening. At some point, it's going to be hard and uncomfortable, and I'm going to feel outmanned and question why I ever thought I could draw in the first place, or paint, or sculpt, or needlepoint, or quilt, it just doesn't even matter what your creative journey is. You thought you could do some hook stitch that you just reached too far for, but you're not going to grow those skills if you live in your comfort zone.
Yeah.
You have to constantly be asking yourself to be a little uncomfortable as an artist if you want to continue adding to that skill bag. So my real advice to you is if sometimes, especially if you're like, hey, I need to grow my voice, or hey, I need to grow my art skills to that next level, then almost if something really deeply scares you, do it.
Yeah. Oh, that's
right?
True.
Because it's art. It's not heart surgery. It's not like you said, well, this particular brain surgery is terrifying. Right? That would be totally different. And all the brain surgeons like, yeah, that should get researched first.
Yeah.
And then Lisa's like, no, our brain surgeon says brain surgery is easier than art. But regardless, whatever it is that you're doing, it's not life or death. The worst that happens is a canvas that you're not... Don't quit in the middle, though.
Right.
Push through. Take it to its full conclusion. And then gesso over it if you really, really hate it and it makes you unhappy.
Yeah.
That's what I do. Some people go out and buy a bunch of art supplies, and that's also a good solution. I need new water, baby. I'm
do
sorry.
You?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, hold on.
That I can't get to.
I will fix that. I just need to push a
button.
So
I could do another Q&A while you're watering.
Okay. I will. Do you want to do some Q&A?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, hold on a second. I will go.
And then I'll finish this up. So
yeah, and
Patricia knows what's going to be right here, and I'm going to show her how to do that. So she's got that, and you guys are going to be excited. And then I got the planets. I got to twinkle some stars here, and then he'll be done. So it's not too much longer. Sorry, I kidnapped y'all.
We're about
into T-minus, the space
eagle. So we could say T-minus 10 minutes here?
No, 20.
20? Okay. So we're about 10 minutes out till 2 hours. So just letting you, I'm just pulling this
out. Oh, okay. Well, that's for as involved as he is, though, we just kind of like did him.
Yeah, let's see if I can go.
Usually I'm like, this is your brush. This is the brush stroke. This is how
you go.
Okay.
So I'm going to get you some water.
Hi, Maddie. Luke, cover with gesso. The more you follow your dream paint. I love that. Thank you, Lynn.
Yes.
Yeah, just you can microwave it. I don't think YouTube does a live subscriber count. It will probably show up later tomorrow. YouTube does not do a live subscriber count, Snarkles, but believe it or not, TubeBuddy and several other analytics tools do, and they're very accurate and will count the up and down. I don't know why they can do it and YouTube doesn't do it. Will there be a supply list and traceable for tomorrow? Yes and yes for both, and they will be up like right ahead of time. And then Danielle's like, you can always kidnap me. All right, girl, let's go. 100,021 subs. Tomorrow is a collab with Angela and Cinnamon, correct? Says Colleen. Yes, thank you, Colleen. Tomorrow is an Angeluni collab. If you don't know what that is me and a very good YouTube friend of mine. Actually, she's one of those YouTubers we mentioned earlier who was talking to me early on. And honestly, she's a lot of why I'm on the platform. We're going to do a thing, and she's got a beautiful candle she's doing later on, and I'm done. So you can just art live all day, and you can find out more about those things in this weird Facebook group we have called Angeluni. Very friendly place. We're friendly. From Daniel Cinnamon, what was the first painting you've done, and do you still have it? Daniel, the first painting that I did was this chicken, and my mom turned it into statuary. I have a blog about it, and I don't still have it, and but I wish I did. Keep your kids' artwork.
But we do have the first painting from the Sherpa.
We do have the first painting from the Sherpa. We have that. John never let me get rid of any of the Sherpa paintings. Lynn, thank you for saying I deserve what I'm living today, and I hope all of you feel deserving of any of the good stuff that's happening in your life. And John takes my chat away.
Yeah. So we're going to...
John takes my chat when I get too chatty. That's okay. I see how you are.
You see how I am? You
see
what
I'm doing? You are.
What am I doing here?
You're tricky.
Yeah.
You're tricky, tricky. It's tricky to rock around, and right on time, it's tricky. I feel like.
Ooh, I pushed the wrong button, and I got our other music there. Hold on.
Did you take us off air?
I no.
Because that would be terrible. But they don't even get to see how the painting finishes. That's so mean. I don't know why that makes me giggle either. Because it's really mean, but also kind of funny. You'll never know how it ends.
There's so many
buttons.
I don't
know if it's frustrating to not know how a painting ends. Like, I don't know what that's like.
We start and stop stories all the time. So it's like, wait, is there...
Yeah, but I really don't know how I feel about this new you can binge an entire season and then wait another year.
Oh, hey, Ian Jackson. He came to remind us of all of our fans on Endor. There could be Ewoks on that planet.
I hope you're doing great, Ian.
So,
Ian does YouTubery,
he
too.
He does. We have a lot of YouTubery people. Oh, and art games. People want to see more art games.
We'll be doing more of that. Some art games. I got to talk to Angela, see if she'll do an art game with me.
Yeah, that's coming. We definitely have more of that.
Angela, will you game with me?
We're going to be doing more of that this year.
The Andersons versus the Cooney art game.
We'll see.
I don't know if I'm up for taking on Mark's stick figures. I don't know.
Yeah, we'll do some more art games here soon.
Well, okay. So we have that. It has a swirly.
That looks good. I like
it. Could be better. But I gotta do some stuff. You know, you gotta decide, is this a green planet? Is this is there habitation on your planet? How is the planet doing? And really think about these things when you're creating them so that they feel like they're real orbs. This is a real place that you can live, and it has much water. It's real. Are you real? Give it some clouds. Otherwise, it won't be real. They're like little marbles. I'll collab with a marble maker right now. I'll tell you that right now.
Mm-hmm.
I just realized that. Do you ever have like a collabing realization, like right in the middle of painting something? Be like, I would collaborate with a marble maker just to see this in reality in blown glass.
Now, we're not sure if this is going to stay up on Facebook or not.
We don't know what Facebook does. Facebook is its own beast, isn't it?
But we're going to try to leave this up in all the places for you guys to rewatch again.
All the places.
And if for whatever reason it's taken down from all the places, I will edit it and re-upload it. So.
You will?
Yes.
Like into some sort of short see it? Should we do that, like a highlight video, instead of make people sit through the whole thing?
Well, no,
but then people be like, I don't know how to paint the eagle now, and you've disappointed me greatly.
Mm.
I love when people are like, you have disappointed me greatly. Dude. He didn't know. Sorry. All right, so we've got a couple planets. Are we happy with our planets?
I love it.
Now we've got to come back and do some cool awesomeness for Patricia.
Okay, what we got there?
So, I've already got it out.
Oh, yeah.
I've got the teal out, and I've got the
thing
out, and hopefully that's zinc.
Oh, it's your teal. How do you see it?
Yeah, and I've got my little teal.
Where are you going to go?
I am going to go a shocking place. I'm going to go up here. All right, and so I'm adding this teal to the upper part of the clouds. I've been getting asked a lot about lightning, a lot lately.
About lightning?
Mm-hmm. And Patricia just went through a pretty harrowing experience.
Mm-hmm.
Her husband was actually hit by lightning, which is not cool or lucky, and I don't recommend it to anybody.
No, it's not.
It's very damaging to your whole body.
Yeah.
And we're definitely wishing that he's in a constant path of recovery,
mm-hmm.
you know, and that they're getting all the support they need. But one of the things that she wanted to do to work through that experience was to be able to talk about that in her art. So, I'm going to try to, without reference now, kind of get back into my headspace where I remember what this really looks like for people. So, there is some element unknown here because I'm not using a reference. But now, I think I've got it.
When you're...
So, see, we've got that blue there.
Oh, we go back to it. Yes.
We've got the blues, and I got the blues. I'm going to get a teeny tiny little fiddly brush.
Oh, Patricia says thank you very much, Cinnamon.
Oh, you're so welcome, sweetie. This is a 00. Patricia's one of the mods in Angeluni,
mm-hmm.
and she spares you stuff y'all don't even know. Because we moderate our group. It takes a little longer for stuff to post up, but then also no one tries to sell you anything weird or... show you anything weird. So I'm just wiggling this out. The thing to think about lightning is that it is unpredictable. Mm. So it won't be like a tree in any way. See how that's kind of going?
Kind of all, you know.
Fiddly.
Yeah.
Be fiddly. And I really like using an aqua.
Now, there are some questions. You don't like oil paints.
No, I like them.
Or you don't use them.
I am not an oil artist. I think oil is tremendous, and I think oil gets a bad rap. It's not toxic.
It's just you like the properties of acrylic.
I want to be done, man. I don't want to be waiting 3 months to gesso or, varnish a painting.
Yeah.
I am not that patient. That.
Oh.
Right?
Yeah.
So, I think it's fun to drop a little lightning down onto your space eagle for sure.
Oh, there it goes. Okay. I almost lost you.
Me?
I was pushing buttons and not paying attention.
Where would you put me?
Well, because sometimes I get behind on the switching.
Do you ever like think, man, if you knew what you knew now, then would you still ask the question?
Oh, wait, 42. I'm sticking to my answer. So
just
no,
trying to just think about like places it could land.
I love that. That looks so cool. I'm looking over your right shoulder because
So we have that up there, right?
Yeah.
And one thing that we can do, I think I've got some fluid out still, is we can come even in the center, right? Because lightning, like fire, is what? A little hotter in the center, isn't
oh,
it?
Oh, I see. Oh, that's cool.
Just give it a little.
So, we. This is.
Hopefully, this is helpful, Patricia.
There's some Stephen Colbert fans in the audience who are like, Stephen would love this painting.
Dude, I hope he decrees me in his fuzzy hat something.
Yeah.
Just anything from the fuzzy hat. I'll take it. I'm going to do some twinkle stars. So this one to me was already like begging to be a twinkle star. It was like, be a twinkle star.
You made me laugh there.
Hmm?
You got me laughing there. That would be awesome.
Fuzzy hat?
Something decreed from the fuzzy hat. That would be awesome.
Ugh, that's annoying. So you're about to see what John was talking about earlier. I don't like that that's not.
What are you doing?
I'm taking that off. I didn't like that it wasn't straight. I'm going to just get rid of it. Because you can do that, as John mentioned earlier. You cannot do this with student paint.
That's just water that you're using?
Yeah, this is dry underneath, and so I can kind of lift this up because I don't like it. Wasn't dry, you know. I'm gonna dry it.
That was really cool. All right.
Just wasn't. I didn't like the line.
You didn't like that line, so
I didn't like it.
You just undid it.
I just ended that line, and it felt like painting it out. So we washed it out. You know, you gotta like what you're doing.
Yeah.
Otherwise, why are you doing it?
Now you.
Now, you have some explanation for why in pictures this is a thing.
Oh, that you get those little lines?
Yeah, I like them.
Oh, yeah. Well, you're adding some extra ones there.
I am. I'm being arty.
So, these little lines that you see, these diffraction lines, typically come from telescopes. So, when you take a photo with a telescope, a lot of them were what we call Newtonian telescopes. Reflectors. There you go, a Newtonian reflector telescope, which means that there's a little mirror up at the top of it that is held above the primary lens, and the arms that hold it in place are called the spider, and that's what you're actually seeing here is the light reflecting off those little arms that hold that that reflector in the center of a big telescope. Or hold the center optical assembly, and it kind of refracts off of those and makes those lines. And so you can always tell a photo that was taken with a reflector telescope that has those spiders in them.
But I feel like in space.
But it looks really cool, you know.
There must always be these. So John's used to seeing a grip of them.
And, you know... similarly, if you other telescopes have iconic images that you can pick up. But where will this be at? We will we're gonna leave this up everywhere we can leave it up. So probably for sure on YouTube you should be able to find it. Probably
just in
on
case
Twitch.
People are at work and they couldn't come attend and they wanted to scan through. Yep, I'm gonna put a reflection in his eye.
Are you?
Yeah.
Oh. He's looking fierce.
There we go. Give him one reflection here.
Wow.
I feel like we're there, John.
I think you're there.
I think it's sign time.
I'm pretty excited about that.
I think it's signing the eagle time, and I think I'm going to drop that here. That's where I'm going to drop it.
I'm going to throw on our music here.
What's our music? Oh, our music.
Yeah.
Like our music.
Let's see here.
100,000, babe. Thank you. Thank you to the community. See y'all at 11 tomorrow to paint.
And I'm going to come here in just a second here.
To paint a... I'm going to stop now. I feel like I kind of covered the idea. You get where I was going.
Yeah.
Did they get where I was going?
I think they get where you're going.
Follow your dreams, and you will get a space galactic eagle. Or at least some other cool thing you want to hang on your wall. Because you can art. You can art.
You can't see what's going on over there. I'll fix that.
I still can't. Oh, it's all tropical button. Leaves.
What did I push? Program.
Oh, I just love it. Looks so good on camera.
Oh, that's why. There we go. Now we're all back. I don't dance very well.
Oh, I'm going to move over and let him have his full moment. I feel like I danced a lot this year. I can be John.
I don't know. Isn't there some sort of like it's like mime movement. I don't know. Oh, we have dance lessons coming up, don't we?
We do.
Dance
lessons. I got that for Christmas. It won't help, but okay. We're going to go anyways. There's John's mouth.
Attracted your
I married him. Thank you guys so much. I hope this was a fun celebration of how we got here. What you can do with your art skills if you feel like following along.
See,
and
now
painting.
You have to step forward because I moved the camera. So you have to. There you
What's
are.
What to do
now.
With your art skills? If you would like to paint, I'd love to show you how. If you have a friend that would like to paint, tell them it's here. It's free. Anytime. All kinds of art, really supportive. No mean statements. And lots of love.
Yeah. And I'm going to. Now I have to get all my
and
stuff.
And this goof will continue. So, you know, you got to like goof. If you don't like goof, then you need your art to be serious.
Yeah.
And I'll talk about serious art things because I have training and all. I just don't want to be serious about it. It is just paint, right?
Yeah. But, you know, seriously, guys, this, I have to say. Now that I'm all settled back over here in my buttons and I'm like, you know, ready to get the... thank you. I'm going to say thank you. I love you guys. This was so much fun doing this with you, being here with you. I look forward to the next 100,000. You, I love you guys. I love you, Cinnamon. Thank you for
I
taking the journey.
I love you too, baby. And I love you guys.
All right. I pushed the buttons.